Okay, hi, my name is Zion. Today I'll be talking about why you should go for Zend Certified Engineer Certification. A bit of note about the italics on top. Actually, the original title was Zend PHP Certification and was supposed to be a 5-minute talk. So Michael changed, gave me a longer title, so I have to talk longer today. A bit about myself, as I say, my name is Zion. So first thing, a disclaimer, I'm not from a training agency. I'm not selling any courses here. So everything is in a personal capacity. Currently, I'm working as a team lead, overseeing a team of developers across many platforms, from Android, iOS, Java, Ruby, Node.js, and finally, of course, PHP. So the context behind this talk was recently I passed the Zend PHP 7.1 certification, and Michael invited me to give a talk over here. You notice the name of the cert, that is my official birth cert name. Yes, correct. Because actually when you go for the exam, right, you need to show two forms of identification, one with photo, one with signature. So you have to use official name. Yeah. So what I'll be doing is I'll be briefly going through some certifications that I've gotten before, and then doing comparison to Zend certification. First up, this is the biggest size I could get. This was the first certification that I got. That was from 2010 to April 2011. It's actually 3 certifications. I actually went to a local training center, signed up for a course. It was about 3-month full-time course. It was about 7K. Yeah. At the time, there was C-Track funding, so government funding, and they funded up to 80%. Once you pass the exam, you can make a claim and you will get your money back up to 80%. Later on, I heard that it actually dropped to 50%. Right now, I'm not quite sure what's the terms already. So for these 3 certifications, I had to take 1 foundation exam, 4 MCTS exams, MCTS being Microsoft Certified Technical Skills exam. So that one tests you more on the programming language itself and the syntax, that's it. And 3 MCPD, Professional Developer exams. So the Professional Developer exams, they test you more on your architecture, your design patterns. And also, it was through this course that I first learned about the model view controller concept. And that was in 2011. In April 2011, I joined my previous company. It was an events company. So they actually did event. They had a few events every year, like the World Gourmet Summit. And they actually used PHP to do websites. So at the time, my manager asked me to actually, why not you pick a PHP framework? Because the previous sites were done in plain PHP. So I look around, I narrowed down Symfony and Zend. The time there wasn't any Laravel yet. I think so, yeah. So my choice for choosing Zend framework was PHP runs on the Zend engine. So Zend is so-called like the company behind PHP. So as long as PHP is around, Zend framework should still be around. So that was my consideration for my boss. I don't want to choose a framework that's here today and gone tomorrow. And thinking on behalf of my HR colleagues, Zend actually provided certification. So I could tell my HR, right, so next time you want to hire more developers, you can look for Zend framework certified developers. So that was in June 2011. And after 1 year of using it, I decided, okay, let's try to take the certification. So I went back to the same local training center. I asked, do you have a Zend framework certification course? We have, but we don't have much takers. So there's only one other person who's interested. Okay, so they contacted them. Okay, so everything was arranged. And 1 week just before the course was supposed to start, the other person back out. So that was about, I think about 4K per person, I think. And the training center called me. So the other person back up, but we still can find the trainer for overseas for you. So that will be about 7K. So at the time, actually, my manager, my boss was quite kind. He was willing to sponsor my course. But I was thinking, right, the exam is about 200 plus 200 Sing dollars. Right? Even if I fail the exam 20 times, right, it's still cheaper than 7K. So I said, okay, heck it. I'll just try it out. And I went for the exam. All the PHP exams is about 70 questions, about 1.5 hours. You book a place, so and then you sit down in front of a computer. It's a mix of MCQ as well as filling the blanks, and you answer the questions on the spot. So thank God I actually passed it, and I got it. So boosted by this, I decided, okay, why not I just take the PHP certification. So that was at the end of the month. Comparatively, the PHP certification is more technical. It tests you more on your syntax, and they will actually show you a lot of code and then ask you what's the output. And actually, it's quite tricky. Like sometimes plus plus x, x plus plus, and then a switch. They will ask you in array, is it haystack first, then needle, or needle first, then haystack? You know, PHP always cannot get its mind about this. So whereas the Zend framework exam was talking more about design patterns, architecture, how the framework components can be used to for a particular workflow. So that was the PHP 5.3. In 2013, there was no new exams. No, like now, like getting a kick, like collecting certifications as a hobby. So at this point, I was thinking, okay, no more new exams, but it would be quite lame if I were to say, why not I just take a Microsoft Certified System Engineer exam? That's very well respected, right? But the thing is, I don't do system administration. So even if I take the exam and I pass it, right, it's like quite lame. So I was thinking, it would be more realistic to actually take a certification for something that you actually use often or use at work. So I was a web developer, so I took a MySQL. This have two exams to pass. Let's call it exam A and exam B. Exam A, I failed the first time. Very hard pain. That was about $260. And all my certifications, I use my own money. Even the Zend framework one the first time, the one was my own money. I didn't claim from the company. So finally, I passed both exam A and exam B, and I got this in 2013. In 2012, that was about October, I read about ZenCon. ZenCon is the biggest annual PHP conference organized by Zen itself, and it's usually in US. So I was very interested in that one because they were going to announce Zen Framework 2. So I decided, actually, I want to ask my manager, I want to take leave to go. And he was also very kind. The boss and my manager, who happens to be the boss son, was very kind and said, we'll sponsor you the flight ticket and the conference ticket. So I went off to Santa Clara, San Jose, California, and I learned a lot of things like Git, Composer, and of course Zend Framework 2. So that was in 2012. Around March 2014, they released the exam. Zend Framework 2 was quite different from Zend Framework 1. Breaking a lot of stuff, so it was very different. So they released a new exam, and tried it, yeah. And thank God I got it again. And now we have a blank page. Nothing. What happened was in 2014, I actually got retrenched. And I was thinking, at my age, right, I want to try freelancing, because if I don't try, I'll be too old already. So as a freelancer, right, the money was very tight. Plus, there was no other relevant certifications for me to take. I was picking up a little bit of Swift, a little bit of Ruby, and other languages here and there, but just touching on the surface. So I found that it'd be quite lame if I were to just take, let's say, a Ruby certification just for the sake of certification. So don't have, nothing. There was a PHP 5.6 certification exam. But the problem was the logo would just say Zend PHP Engineer. There's no mention of the version, no mention of the year. I think quite a number of people in the community didn't really like it because it's like, oh, I can take this and then 10 years later still say that, oh, I'm a Zend PHP Engineer, whereas the version that you took for was probably outdated many a decade ago already. So I didn't go for that. And in February, that was around, I think, Valentine's Day, I received an email from Zend. So they say, oh, finally, we have released the certification exam for PHP 7.1. I've been using PHP 7 since June last year. I use it together with Zend Expressive at work. So they told me, okay, you are existing Zend certified engineer, so you get a discount. So the exam is about US$195. We will give you a $70 discount. That's about $100. Wow, sure. So together with it, I also bought the PHP 5.6 study guide from Zend. The PHP 7 study guide will only be available in April. So I'll be kanjong, so that I'll just try my luck. And it was a good thing I bought a study guide because I got reminded of how tricky the questions were. It's really quite tricky. So I went through revision. In addition to the study guide, I also went through the change log from PHP 5.3 to 5.4 to 5.5 to 5.6 to 7 to 7.1. I was doing, the day before the exam, I was at DevSecCon, and actually Michael was sitting beside me. Then he was looking at my laptop. How come he's attending a conference and he's looking through the PHP change log? Yeah. So I was preparing for the exam as well on the day. So some benefits of Zend certification. One exam only. For the mic, nobody from Microsoft here, right? Okay. For the Microsoft one, it's an average about 3 to 4 exams just to get one professional developer certification. Okay, Oracle has 2 exams. Zend, only 1. There's discounts for Zend PHP conferences, usually ZenCon, and the exams, like what I mentioned just now, like $70. On top of it, now for the Microsoft and Oracle, till now, I don't really see much benefits, except like probably you can access their merchandise, you can buy t-shirts, say I passed my MySQL exam, okay, something like that. But other than that, I don't see any explicit benefit after passing the exam. I'll show you the one of the websites just now later. For Zend certified engineer, when you pass a certification, you get a free perpetual Zend Studio license. Zend Studio is basically like IDE, like Android Studio, Visual Studio. And perpetual means what? You are eligible to all the minor upgrades for free. So let's say you get it for Zend Studio 9. From 9.1 to 9.9999, right? You get free upgrades. Zend Studio 10, you probably have to buy a new license. So I pass for Zend certification, so I have 4 Zend Studio license, which actually I don't use. I actually use Sublime Text at work. So you can also apply for the free ZC, means Zend Certified Engineer. You can apply for the free ZC license for the Zend Server Developer Edition. This I just found out. When I went over to ZenCon in US in 2012, they also had, they actually will single you out, and they actually have an exclusive lunch for Zend certified engineers. So it was one of the days. So you see all the Zend certified engineers, you come, you mingle with one another, so you kind of feel privileged, feel short. So they really treat you, say, wow, you're special. Where else for the other certifications, I don't get any special treatment so far. if you are in LinkedIn, they have a special LinkedIn group membership for Zend certified engineers as well. Okay, Zend URL pages. Now, when you become a ZCE, right, your name, your profile automatically goes on to the Zend yellow pages. So it's public worldwide. I am going to show first the one for Microsoft and then the one for Oracle. Okay, let me see. Okay. For Microsoft, it used to be if you want to show your transcript to an employer, you tell employer, okay, please go to this website and then key in my transcript ID and then access code. Okay, so after that, you go in and then you see your transcript. Is my internet still on? Yes. Okay, yeah, that's great. For the benefits, if you were to click on your benefits and exams, actually you just come here. They invite you to actually pay for more exams and more training. Discounts on books, I'm not quite sure. And of course, there's a MCP merchandise. I think you can buy a mug, which I didn't buy. Okay. Next one will be Oracle. Okay, let's talk about benefits first. So same thing, you get Oracle certification branded merchandise, which I didn't get as well. Now, Oracle is a bit more restrictive. If you want to show your employer or your prospective employer that you're Oracle certified, right? Microsoft at least has a public page. You just share your so-called transcript ID and access code to everyone. But this one, right, you need to go in. Okay, please scan your employer's email. Then after that, your employer will receive two emails. The first email is the link to the transcript. The second email is a password, and the email link will expire in 5 days. Okay, I have no idea why this. Okay, and finally, of course, Zend Your Pages is free, probably on the internet, and you can search by country. So this is, you just Google for Zend Your Pages. You can go by country. This is the one in Singapore. Currently, there are only 31. Hopefully, there will be more. I think our neighboring countries have more. So they will show you certification type. Hey, oh, Michael. Okay, one of our pioneers, I believe he also conducted certification training courses at the beginning, right, as part of the PHP user group.
Many years ago,
okay.
The first PHP 5 certified engineer here.
Yes. Okay, quite well known in our community as well. Okay, let's look at page 2. Anyone?
Yeah,
Yanhong
further down.
Okay,
wait.
Ah, okay.
CJ.
Ah, Chen Jie. No face, eh? Okay. Okay, let's look at page 4 first. Because I'm on page 3. Okay, page 4 and page 3. This is my one.
Wow, most illustrious.
Okay, so actually, if you click on it, let me see.
Illuminati or something?
Is it like Illuminati? No, I'll explain. So actually, they will show you the your certifications and the date that you got it. One good thing about this new certification I thought I got there is that now it's a balance between green and blue. Okay, let's see. Okay, talking about certification, so certification is not is all and end all. Now, taking all these certifications, having a lot of them doesn't mean that I'm an expert. Okay, in fact, actually, when I went through the exams, right, it's like going back to a student again, you're sitting in front of the computer, and then half of the questions, you're not sure whether you're correct or not. And then and when you're preparing for the exam, you actually learn quite a lot. Like, say, hey, oh, I didn't know there'll be this sort of casting issue in PHP. Or things like when I went for the Microsoft course, I learned about the model view controller concept for the first time. So actually, going for all this is, for me, it was more so to challenge myself. Like especially right now, I'm a team lead. So most of the time, I'm doing code reviews. And or when one of my developers is on leave, and there's anything to fix, I'll fix it. But I hardly do any coding now. So this was like, life was getting a bit boring. So okay, let's try to stress myself out. So in conclusion, I would like to explain about the concept about this logo. I designed this logo when I was freelancing. So actually my company back then is financial, so providership, right? It's called Int Zone. So INT stands for integer zone. I like maths, doesn't mean I'm good at maths. Insight makes use of Euclidean geometry, point, line, polygon. And then most importantly, there's prime numbers, two. Inside, there's two shades, half is gray, half is white. Three, the triangle. Five, the pentagon, and seven colors of the rainbow. So according to mathematical proofs by Euclid and Euler, there is an infinite number of prime numbers, the same of which can be said of learning, that there's no end. So actually all this thing about going for certification is like, it's more so to actually try to learn more and then to see whether I can meet the baseline and ultimately to keep on challenging myself to learn more. So actually my motto, personal motto is actually this, sempre discens. It is a Latin phrase which means always learning. Yeah, that's all, thank you.
Questions for Zion? No?
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Zion.
Thank you.